What you are looking at is a satellite view of a massive circular feature within Canada, which is sometimes informally referred to as the Eye of Quebec. It measures 70 kilometers or 43.5 miles wide, containing the circular René Levasseur Island in its center, which is surrounded by a rain lake known as the Manicouagan Reservoir. This vast feature is not a caldera, but instead represents the fourth largest confirmed impact crater on the planet, which was originally 100 kilometers or 62.1 miles wide. The Manicouagan Crater can be found in central Quebec, where it is located within deeply glacially carved landscape of the Canadian Shield, being approximately 530 kilometers north-northeast of Quebec City. Despite Manicouagan Crater's vast size, scientists were not able to find any direct evidence that this crater's formation triggered a mass extinction, despite having about 56% the diameter of another North American impact crater, which absolutely did trigger a mass extinction event. However, new evidence was recently presented which contradicts the prior notion. In other words, the impact which formed the basin and island where a lake now sits was absolutely catastrophic. To understand how catastrophic, we need to travel back in time to a period 214 million years ago at a time during the late Triassic period when dinosaurs had only recently become fairly dominant land animals. At the time, the majority of the world's landmass was interconnected as a supercontinent Pangaea, including almost the entirety of modern North and South America, Africa, Antarctica, Madagascar, and Australia, with Eurasia having only recently broken away from the rest of the landmass. It was a hot planet, as average temperatures were 5 Celsius or 9 degrees Fahrenheit warmer than they are today, with the eventual impact site being located much closer to the equator, specifically about the same distance that Mexico's city of Nogales is today. Yet, while animals such as rauisuchids were traversing the forested landscape built on top of 2-billion-year-old gneiss, something unexpected simultaneously occurred in the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter. Two main belt asteroids collided, one which was likely upwards of 50 kilometers wide, which had a differentiated crust, mantle, and core, and a smaller, several kilometer wide asteroid which struck at a shallow angle. This caused a large portion of the bigger asteroid's crust to be ejected as large fragments into space before solidifying back together as a rock type known as an achondrite. This new asteroid then began its oblong orbital path towards the inner solar system, which took it across Earth's orbit. The asteroid in question measured a whopping 9.41 kilometers or 5.85 miles wide and had a mass of 1.3 trillion metric tons. As it accelerated in the inner solar system, it reached Earth's upper atmosphere, at which time it was traveling at a velocity of 17 kilometers per second or 38,000 miles per hour. A bright streak of light soon lit up the sky, and then, only 7 seconds later, a cataclysmic impact occurred. In mere seconds, energy equivalent to the detonation of 44.4 million megatons, or 44.4 trillion tons of TNT was released, creating shaking equivalent to a magnitude 9.7 earthquake. Dozens of cubic kilometers of ground were shot high into the atmosphere, the vast majority of which would subsequently fall back to the ground and start fires across multiple hemispheres. But before that could occur, the intense thermal radiation started off the mass extinction event, immediately igniting everything in a 1,110 kilometer radius. As the several thousand mile per hour shockwave raced outwards in all directions, a large mass of rock at the edge of the newly formed 21 kilometer deep impact crater suddenly acted like a liquid and flowed into the bottom of the newly formed crater. This material then collided and was forced upwards, flowing outwards until it slightly cooled and became a hardened mass, forming a central peak and reducing the crater's depth to only 1.2 kilometers. However, because this collision was so energetic, this material would not fully cool until a whopping 5,000 years later. All vegetation would go on to be flattened by the sheer force of the shockwave in a 2,200 kilometer radius, while all trees within a 3,500 kilometer radius would experience some damage. Due to the widespread wildfire soot and debris carried into the atmosphere, a short-term impact winter would follow. acting as a bottleneck which many species were simply unable to survive, this medium-sized mass extinction event wiped out 58% of ammonites, 26% of radiolaria, and 33% of condonants, with this for the latter marking the beginning of a three-stage death spiral, which would end with the entire class termed Conodonta going completely extinct. Over the following 214 million years, at least the top 1,000 meters of this impact crater was removed by erosion, creating its modern appearance.